It got some really cool functions that I'm gonna show you. And one of them is also that it shows your amps that your servos are pulling. And you'll be really wondering how much amps your servos are really pulling. And if your BECs are up to delivering the amps that those servos need. And you're gonna be really surprised how much it is. Hello everybody, welcome to a new episode of GYAC. In today's episode we are going to be reviewing that we use in airplanes, the 9-gram servo. It is completely plastic. This is fully metal, and this one is fully metal. This one goes 300 degrees. This gun only goes 60 degrees. But it's very heavy duty and can pull, has a lot of torque, can pull a lot of kilos. This time we are going to be doing a short press on the moving button. First you press exit, and then we already is in linear mode, so we got control with a servo knob, and we already get it seeing some amps that is drawing, but as soon as we stop the amps is falling away. So let's do it again, but then go small press, and then we have P1, that is the thank you. trick that this servos also can run on 6 volts. So let's press exit, then long time hold the key. Here we got into the settings where we can do the voltage output that we need later for if you want to test an EEC and a brushless motor and spin it out. You got the cycle count, lowest input, safety temperature, 70 degrees Celsius. Okay, change the backlight and the buzzer, the language, the theme style from light to dark, and you can calibrate the knob and the cycle counter clear. And then you can go back to the default settings. What we want to do now to improve from 5 volts to 6 volts, we can set the voltage output to 6 volts that's going to the servos. And now let them go and run again. Now check the numbers of the amps. And the 9 grand servo is going up to almost 6 milliamps. Well, the 25 kilo 300 degree servo is staying around 500 milliamps. But the old MG995 is going up to 2000 milliamps, close 1900. So that's extreme amount of amps that your back needs to supply to keep your servo working. And let's say you have 3 of them or 4, then you need a separate back for each servo. And 1 amp or 2 amp backs, or sometimes U-backs that come BSCs, this is a 2 amp. It's just not enough for this big servo. Let's tell it alone stand that you have several of these big servos. That's why I like this advanced servo tester from ToolKitRc. The ST8 get my thumbs up. I'm really liking it. It's a good buy, and we find the links down below. Thank you very much, Hobby Powder. Thank you. And now let's also show that you can test an EEC and a motor, so you can run your motors in and see if all the components work before you're building it inside your plane. For that, we have to disconnect all 3 servos because we're gonna maximize the output voltage. I don't want to smoke them. Let me connect to the first. If you like this product, then you can find the links again down below. I want to thank you all for watching, and I hope to see you next time. And if you have any questions, then leave them down below. Hope to see you next week. Goodbye. This was DIYRC signing out. Please like and subscribe.